What's up, everybody? It's your boy Unlimited Versus. And what we're gonna do is I'm gonna do a little basic little tutorial in the beginnings of FL Studio. So first thing first, it's gonna when you download it, upload it, and install it, however you want to put it, whatever language you want to use, it's gonna look something like this. This is gonna be like some of the first pack you're gonna have, unless you already have stuff, unless you already know about like DAWs and folders and files and stuff. So it's gonna be in here where your drums and stuff up here. Yeah, okay. You got a file. You open your files and stuff like this. This is your ten most recent projects that you worked on right here. You can hit Alt 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 9, and 0 all the way down to open those straight up. Here you can import a MIDI file, export files, save. Pretty common sense right here. Save a new version, save as, save, open from a template. FL have different templates that you can start out with. All right, say like, if you wanna do rock, no. See, FL Studio, pretty much everything you need to start producing rock tracks. Plug in your instruments and start recording. Includes mixer routing with mixer part right on the mixer dock and mouse at master part on the left mixer dot, placeholder, color coder, and many other production tools. So yeah, this is just one of the templates. This is the template that comes preloaded already, so you can already go ahead and start doing stuff. Let's go back to the basic minimum. I'll be back on base. Okay, so here. Okay, let's keep going across here. You got your patterns. This is how you can your patterns is how you're gonna start to build your beat, instrument, sound, or whatever you wanna call it. Let's see my camera zooming out. You got your view, you can pick these, you can just the different views, the plugin picker, the project, mixer, piano roll. Here's your different options, your MIDI file. MIDI settings, this is how you set up your MIDI controller, your keyboards and stuff like that. Not right here. Here's my I can do a quick look thing. Basically, you're gonna come here kind of. I can do another one. And here's all your controls and stuff right here. That's other videos that explain it, but that's just in a nutshell. See, it's gonna come with the kick, clap, hi hat, and snare. Oh, so like it's gonna come in a number 1, 2, 3, and 4. But like with me, with my files, let's see. So with my files, where is it? Okay, so the preview mix track. This is the this right here, the metronome. I got this on that track, so when I start putting other stuff, other sounds, plugins, instruments, whatever, I always start from the next one over. But I don't know if you guys see my template is different, because it's already preset that way. And then plus there's like bus channels and stuff, so I usually start on like 8, 9, 10, 11, something like that, unless I start with a loop sample. Say from Cymatics or something like that. But yeah, this is the settings and stuff like that. This is the RCL audio buffer. Just deal with your buffer and stuff like that. Your input, output. This is your driver. For those of you guys who has I think it's called a Focusrite. I don't actually have one, as you can probably tell by the sound. Excuse me, Focusrite, that thing, that's what that's for, doing all those different sound drivers. Tools, you got your tools, your smart find, you just search for stuff, click all macros. This one, I explain this a little bit more, especially this one right here. Remember this right here. Macros, purge, unused audio clips. So, you got your pattern, you can choose between patterns and songs, play, stop, record. This is the tempo. You can choose the tempo. This is the song position right here. This is where the song's gonna start at. This is typing to keyboard. You click this and your keyboard can either say, like, if you don't have a MIDI controller, like a actual, like a keyboard MIDI controller, then you can use your keyboard as a MIDI controller. That's what that's for. But at the same time, you can't. Next, you have this right here. This is a snap to grid. You can change the grid size. Right now, it's in bar. Each one of these is a bar. It tells you the size of the grid, what the measurements you are that are being used right now. This is by beats. And you got half beats. You got half beat, quarter, six, and then you go in steps, 1/6, none. You got cell, line, and main. You got events and markers too, so you can just think that's where you can like some two markers maybe. Oh well, we'll see. This is the pencil tool, the drawer tool, just drawing different stuff. Whatever you have, wherever you at. If I'm on a kick, it's gonna draw in that kick. If I'm on a clap, it's gonna draw in that right there. This is the paintbrush, same thing. You just paint it straight across. This is the paintbrush, just painting straight across. This is the delete it. The paint, this is the mute. You can mute those like that. This is the slip, where you can change where the samples start and stop. This also can be used to when you can adjust the tempo and stuff like that. And you got the cut tool. That's what you're gonna use. That's gonna come in handy with this tool. This, how you cut, these are gonna be the measurements that you cut. So say like if I had this, if I have this here and I wanna cut this in half, and let's say we in bar mode, it's not gonna let me do that here. Let's do this. Yeah, let's do this. So say like if I wanna cut this right here, I can't do that. I can only do it in the bars, cause that's how the grid is. These are your measurements that you're gonna cut right here. See that this is fourth. And if you wanna go off the grid, you just hold the alt button like that. And you can be anywhere and just do that. You can even go sideways. You hold alt and right, I was gonna say right trigger. right click. Like you're gonna have that red line and it's gonna delete that automatically. If you just hold it, if you just cut it normally, it'll just cut it like that. This is select, the select tool, pretty much that's what it says. The zoom, you can click on something and it zooms right in. This is the playback. Wherever you click this, it's gonna play that sample and we're at, not everything that you have in here. I can't see my hand. But like everything that you have in here, it's not gonna play, but wherever you click on that, whatever's in this, and I click right here, it's gonna play that. So that's be like, you could be like, what is this? Be like, oh, okay. And that also works on a piano roll too. And this is play pause song right here. And what this does, as you can see, is where it'll stop it. You see what I'm saying? So, all right, now let's make a beat. So here we got our channel rack. Like I said, the default is gonna be just like this. You got your kick, clap, snare. And with me, the way I got my setup, I got my metronome on this, so I don't want my kick and metronome on the same one. So I put this one up 2, 3. Maybe this is two, three, four, five. There. Start with the kick. This is the envelope. This is how you pretty much shape the sound how you want it. It's gonna like this. Now the tech. The delay. Wait for it. That's the longest delay. God damn. Okay, that's her. See, the delay is so long that it just... Yeah. Yeah, there it is. Now you can hold it. Make it short. Make it attack. Now the attack is, that is the attack time. That's how fast it reaches its highest peak. That's what that is. Or I think, or at what point during the song it reaches its highest peak. I usually want my stuff all right there. Unless there's a certain reason that I have it. Anyway. But yeah, that's the kick. Panning, you can use this. You can use this to pan left and right. Volume, the mod, you can mod X, mod Y. Me personally, I like this. Most of the time, I don't really mess with the mod. That's just something real special that I'm doing. Normalize that. You gotta be careful when you click until you be trying to hear it to do, and it'll just automatically go in there like that. So let's see. Delete this. Get you out of there. Oh, here. Let me show you. Say right here. This basic kit. We're not using it. Let's say this was filled. Okay, let's actually do this. So say like we audition all this stuff and we didn't want it, right? And even though we may delete it from here, all right, let's say this, say we only want certain things, right? We want these two, but and we got so many, I'm just getting kind of hard to tell. What you do is you go to Tools, Macros, Purge Unused Audio Clips. Now what's gonna happen is anything that's not being used on the arrangement section, it's gonna delete it. It's gonna delete it. So make sure what you have on here is everything that you wanna keep before you click this. And it's not gonna ask you, are you sure? It is just gonna do it. So click it, bam. That's gone. It's out of my life. We good to go. We only got the things that we need. Let's keep it pushing. Right. So, at 14 minutes. Let's delete this stuff. That's the only thing downside. It doesn't delete this stuff right here, I don't think. Let's see. I don't think it does. Macros, tools, macros, purge, unused. Yeah, it does, yeah. Yeah. Okay, so, oh yeah, Yeah, 15 minutes. Let me see where we. So, let's do a recap. So we went over the bases, went over the file, the edit, the top part. Not sure if you know that this is the master volume, just in case we didn't. You got the pattern, the song, play, pause, record, the tempo. You got your metronome. This is gonna be your beat. It's gonna keep you on beat. All right, don't forget that. This we'll go over this another time. Go over all this good stuff too. I can't remember. I had to rewatch the video and see what I talked about. I just had to do all this other game. But thank you for watching. I appreciate you viewing. Thank you for being here with me. I really appreciate it. It's been awesome. It's been fun. So hit me up at LennonVersus.com. Damn, that feels so good to say. Click the link in the bio. Hit me up on my Instagram. Let me know what you got. Peace.